All right, today I'm going to show you one of the most important things for helping people navigate through your website, and that is menus, whether that be menus in the footer, menus in the header, widget menus. Options are endless. Let's get into it. So this is our menu that we have at the moment, this one right here. So this is a fairly standard menu, but how do we create that? So the first thing we want to do is we want to come across here to appearance, and you can see in appearance, we've got menus. So this is just on your WordPress admin dashboard. So just be logged in there. So we're just going to click on menus. So you can see here all the menu items that I have available that make up that menu, this one here, that I showed you just a second ago. So this is a menu that I have already created. If we go across here to manage locations, here you can see the places that you can actually place your menu. Now this is going to vary from theme to theme. So depending on what theme you're using will depend on where you can put your menus. So you can see the main menu, that one that I've just shown you, we have it as a header menu one and also as a mobile menu. It even tells you just up here, your theme supports 4 menus. So this is very theme specific. But let's go back to edit menus here and let's create a new menu. The obvious way to do this is to, of course, click on create a new menu. So we're just going to come down here and we're going to give the menu a name. I'm going to call this secondary because quite simply, we already have our main primary menu. I'm going to create a secondary menu. Now I come here and I can also select where that's going to go. I can make it a header menu 2 or a footer menu. So let's make it header menu 2. And then you're going to click create menu. So from here, we can go over to our pages. This is what we're looking for. And we can start to add things to our menu. So for example, we may want to still show the login page or the cart page. We can look for view all. So that was just the most recent one. So we can go to view all. And we can see what other pages that we have available to use. We can come down here and we can find our posts as well. Let's say this might be our most popular post and we want to get that pinned into a menu. So let's add that as well. YouTube videos, we don't have any in there. Custom links, if we don't have anything in the YouTube videos, we can actually then add a custom link, like for example, our YouTube page. You've even got the option to add categories. So if you've used categories on your website, you can add a specific category so that it will show up things that are associated. So let's add the gadgets category to our menu as well. If you do want to know more about categories, how they work and how you can use them, then do click the video that I will link at the end of this one. So down here, we can save that as our header menu, save menu. And then if we head over to our homepage, once the page refreshes, you can see there it has adjusted that menu. Now that obviously doesn't look amazing because we have this giant title in here for the particular blog post that we've added. So let's amend that. So we head back over here and let's say to start with, I want this login page to be at the very end. It just would look better that way. So I'm just going to grab it and drag it down to the bottom there. Makes perfect sense to me. And then let's go over here and this is the one that looks too long. I'm just going to press down. There we go. And now I can change the navigation label. So I'm just going to change this to VR kits. There we go. And then save the menu again. Let's go back over to the homepage and just refresh. And there you go. We've got something that looks a lot more streamlined, a lot more user-friendly right there. But let's say we want to add a drop-down menu to something here. So let's say we don't just want the VR kits to sit on its own there. What we can do is we can drag that underneath gadgets and then give it a little subcategory. So we can just do this. And now it's a sub-item just underneath gadgets. So let's save the menu again. Go back up to gadgets and refresh the page. And there we go. So now we only have 4 items available, but in gadgets, the VR kits shows underneath it. So I'll show you that again from home. Gadgets and the VR kits just there. Now you can change how this looks, how it shows and all that kind of thing through your editor, through whatever page editor you're using, whatever blocks editor you're using, even if that is the Gutenberg blocks, and you can change some of it through your theme as well. So you can play around with exactly how that looks and how you want it to look. Now that's obviously just adding the menu to the very top of the screen. You can add it to multiple other areas. I'll show you how to do that one way right now. So let's head down into Appearance again, and it just above Menus is Widgets. So we'll click on Widgets, and from here we're going to scroll down because I want to add this into the footer or the footer area. So I'm just going to open that. And then I'm just going to come up to this blue plus icon here to add a block. You can do this from a multitude of places, but we're just going to do it from here. And what we're looking for is a navigation menu right there. Navigation menu. And I'm just going to drag it right there. Now, I could have pressed the plus icon just down here. That would have worked just the same way. So navigation menu, let's go and select that secondary menu, the one that we've already created. Provided you have created the menu, you'll be able to select it just here. And then we're going to give that a title. So I'm just going to call it new, because why not? So it gives you a rough idea of what that's going to look like. And if we come over and update that, once that's done, we're going to be able to come back over to our page, give it another little refresh there, head down to the bottom. And there we go. We have our brand new navigation menu right there that we can then click through, and it will obviously take us through to the various points. There you go. That's everything tagged with gadgets. I find that category usage of being able to create something in a menu for it is incredibly useful. Now, if you are finding this a little bit technical, maybe a little bit beyond your level, don't worry about it. We're here to help, and you can help yourself in a couple of ways. The first, get subscribed to us here at WP Beginner, because we're going to have, or we do have, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, thousands of tutorials that are going to be able to help you out and get you up to speed. However, if that's not something you've got time for, then check out WP Beginner Professional Services. We've got a whole team of dedicated professionals all waiting to be able to make you your perfect website. It's going to look amazing, and not only that, it's going to perform. If you're looking for website maintenance, speed optimization, SEO optimization, it's all covered with the WP Beginner Professional Services. And if you want to check it out, I'll leave a link down below. Or if you want to check more information about it, click this video right here.